Okay, now I'm gonna show you the way that I personally like to trim clips, and that is on the timeline itself. And so we're gonna start out slow, and then I'm gonna add a few more shortcuts so that you can be crazy efficient fast. So let's go back to the bottom left corner of this panel where we've got our view options, and we're gonna go back to icon view. And now we're gonna select the next shot, shot 22, and we're gonna go all the way down to shot 32. We're gonna shift click to select all of those clips. And then we're just gonna drag these, all of them, over to the timeline. And now I'm gonna zoom in using the key that has a T on it. And we're gonna press our up arrow to go to the beginning of that last shot we added, which was shot 22. Okay, so if we wanted to trim this clip, we could just drag this playhead to the point in the clip where we wanted it to come in. So Miles is gonna lay the bread down here, so maybe I'll start it right here before he lays it down. And then I could click on this clip and I could drag the beginning of the clip in to the playhead, which is an obvious way to trim it. And then to get rid of this gap here, we could just click on it to select it and then press the backspace or the delete key. And by the way, you'll notice that whenever I'm adjusting the edge of a clip that's touching the edge of another clip, I get this split screen up in my program monitor panel, and this split screen is called trim mode. And what it's doing here is you'll see that as I'm adjusting the edge of this clip, so I'm adjusting where this clip starts, it's giving me a preview of what that first frame is going to look like. Then on the left side of this trim view, it's reminding me what the last frame of the previous clip looked like. So this means that these two frames that I'm seeing up here in trim view are going to be back to back in my sequence, in my final video. And so if I'm trying to match the action of me scooping this salad onto the plate, and I see that in this last frame of the last shot, my tongs were a couple inches above the plate, then I need to drag this shot in on the right so that the starting frame, my tongs are in about the same spot. And so trim mode can be super helpful if you're trying to match action between two clips. Now, I don't want you to worry about matching the action or doing any of this stuff right now. This is all stuff we're gonna do in the next lesson on fine cutting, but I also didn't want you to freak out when you saw that split screen up top. Okay, for our next shot here, shot 23, we're gonna drag our playhead to the spot where we want the shot to come in. So right before Miles is gonna slice this bread right here, but instead of dragging the end of our clip in and then clicking and deleting this gap here, because that just took way too long, we are gonna do it faster. We're going to just press the Q key. And then I want you to notice what happened. Pressing the Q key trimmed off everything before our playhead. And so now this looks like a good spot for the shot to go out or for it to end. And so now I'm gonna press the key that's right beside that Q key, which is the W key, and it's going to do the opposite on the other side. So it's gonna trim off everything after the playhead and automatically delete the gap on the other side, right? So basically those two keys, the Q and the W key, are basically gonna turbocharge your editing workflow. I use them all the time to trim off the beginning and the end of my clip. Q for the beginning, W for the end. So let's do the next clip in the same way. So I'm gonna play this clip until I want it to start. Maybe I'll go back just a little bit, press the Q key to trim off the front. Then I'm gonna fast forward until where I want it to end and press the W key to trim off the end, and bam. I mean, it's so fast, it just makes me so happy. Now you might be asking, why are we pressing the Q and the W keys when we're at the end point and the out point on the timeline instead of pressing the I and the O keys like we did when we were trimming clips over here? That's because if you press the I key on the timeline and the O key on the timeline, you're setting an in and out point on the timeline that could include multiple clips. And so it's a totally different thing. And so it's not gonna work for trimming. And so let's just right click here and clear that in and out point. And so if you wanna trim the front and the end of a clip on the timeline, you wanna use the Q and W keys. All right, so let's trim the next few clips in the same way. I'll press the F key to go forward, press the Q key to trim off the front, press the F key to go forward again, W key to trim off the end, F key to go forward, Q to trim off the front, W to trim off the end, Q to trim off the front, F key to go forward, W to trim off the end. So freaking fast, right? Okay, so now I wanna go back because we basically just trimmed three clips of the exact same action. And let's say I decided that I don't wanna use these second two shots. So, you know, I could select these clips, delete them, then I could click on the gap in the timeline and then delete that. But you know what I'm about to tell you, there is a faster way, and that faster way is called ripple delete. So to ripple delete, you're gonna select these two clips and you're gonna right click, and then you're going to go to ripple delete. And that's gonna delete those clips and then cause a ripple effect on your timeline so that all of the other clips after it shift and there's no gap. You can also ripple delete using a shortcut, which I have customized to be the X key. Okay, let's keep going. So I'm gonna press FFF to preview really fast through this next clip because it looks super long and ain't nobody got time to watch it in real time. So let's press FFF. We're gonna go really fast. And now I can remember this one was the one that I thought was a little flat when we were filming it. And so it's the one that I redid and I taped that leaf. Here we go. I taped the leaf in front of the lens and it gave it much more dimension. So I'm gonna go back to this first shot. I know I don't want this one. And so why don't we use what we just learned and I can ripple delete it. And so I'm gonna click to select it. Actually, you know what? I don't even want to click to select it. Like, I am too lazy for that. And the cool thing about Premiere is that you don't even have to click to select a clip. There is a shortcut for that. The shortcut for that is the D key. Whenever you press the D key, it's going to select whatever clip is under your playhead. So if I want to select all of these clips, instead of like shift clicking all of them, or instead of dragging my cursor to select them all, I can just hit the D key and quickly select them all at once if they're all under the playhead. And so now if I want to delete this, I'm going to press the D key to select it, and then I'm going to press the X key to ripple delete it. And by the way, you can also press the D key to select gaps in your timeline. So I could hit the D key here and then delete to delete that gap. All right, moving on. Our next shot, I'm going to press FFF again so I can go through this really fast because it's really long. Okay, right about here looks like a good starting point. So I'm going to press Q to trim off the front, and then I'm going to press FF again to fast forward, and then maybe F again to go a little faster. Okay, right here we really start stuffing our faces. So I don't wanna include that, that is not so cute. So let me press the S key to back up a little bit right before I jam that in my mouth. And now I don't wanna press the W key and trim off the rest of the clip because it's really long and there might be something else that's good in it. So I actually wanna split this clip here. And so to do that, we're gonna need another tool. We've been using the selection tool or this little pointer tool so far, but we're gonna go down to the razor tool. And now we're just going to click on this clip and split it in two. And you can also quickly get to the razor tool by pressing the C key. And then you can get back to the pointer tool by pressing the V key. So just remember C for cut and V for pointer. Another thing about the razor tool is that if you hold down the shift key while you're using it, you'll notice that now we have two little razors there, and that's gonna let you cut multiple clips across all of your tracks at the same time. But if all that wasn't fast enough for you, there is an even faster way to cut, and it is, of course, a keyboard shortcut that I have set to be under my left hand. And that keyboard shortcut is Shift G. So whenever I press Shift G, it's gonna cut any of the clips at the playhead. So I'm gonna press Shift G here, and bam, all those clips are cut. And you'll see that it can cut multiple clips at the same time. And I don't have to toggle between the razor tool and the selection tool. It's just, it is the fastest way to make a cut. All right, up next, we're gonna do a quick recap and you will get your assignment. So I'll see you there.